Hi guys, it's me Kia again. So you guys really seem to like the video where I showed how you can re-stamp your nails without damaging your base using a gel top coat. In case you have not seen it yet, I'll mention it up in the cards and also in the description box below. So do check it out. But for today's video, I'm going to show you another trick which I learned along the years. It is basically using two individual techniques and using them together to open the doors to more creativity. But before going there, have you seen my new nail arts? If not, then do check out it on my Instagram. And if you want to know what the trick is, then keep on watching. I recently got these beautiful UR Sugar nail vinyls from Nail Fiesta. And I'm pretty excited to use them. But I got this hollow nail powder too, and it's been a while since I used one. So what's gonna be? Vinyls, powder, vinyls, powder, vinyls, powder. I'll use both. Oh wait, aren't they quite opposite to each other? One requiring a complete dry base and the other requiring a sticky one? Don't you worry. There is something which can make them fall in love with each other and work together beautifully. As always, the first step is to apply a base color. Hollow shows up best on black, so here I'm using a normal black polish. It doesn't have to be gel particularly, and you can use any color you want. After the base color is completely dry, it's time for the magic element. And yes, the magic element being a gel top coat. I'm using the Born Pretty No Fight one, but you can use any gel top coat you have. I'm applying a thin layer to all of my nails and curing it for a minute. After the gel is fully cured, it's time to stick on the vinyls. I'm using this little heart-shaped one, but again, you can use any which one you want. So as you can see, the vinyl is not sticking properly. This happens due to the curve of the nail. To make it stick better, you can cut the edges of the vinyl, and that will make it fit better to your nail. Now the vinyl is stuck to my nail properly. Let's move on to the next step. The next step is to rub in the powder of your choice. I'm gonna be using this hollow one which I got as a freebie with my order from Nail Art Nail Fiesta. And guys, who doesn't love hollow? Using a sponge applicator, I'm gonna be carefully rubbing in the powder over the vinyl. Make sure you reach every nook and corner and buff the powder well. Once the powder is buffed, it's time for the final reveal, which is peeling off the vinyl. Guys, be very careful while peeling it off because you don't want to mess up the powder and make it go everywhere on the nail. And voila, there you go, a perfect peel. Want a replay? Now using a flat brush, I'm gonna be dusting off the excess powder around my cuticles, making sure I do not touch the nail. Before you mess anything up, it's time to seal it all in. I'm using the same gel top coat, applying a thin layer to all of my nails and curing it for a minute. Now go and wash your hands to remove all the excess powder around your cuticles. And yeah, do come back for the last step, that is hydration. For hydration, I'll be using Bliss Kiss Hydrating Oil, but you can use any product you prefer. Just apply a drop to each of your nail and rub it in. There you go guys, another trick where you can use the gel top coat to use vinyls and powders together. I hope you liked it, and if you did, then do give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I'll catch you in my next one.